Yeah, I come from a Vienna-based law firm. I'm doing data protection since 15 years. You can imagine 15 years ago, people thought I'm a bit crazy doing data protection. What is this? Who needs this? But now I have so much work to do because there are so many questions. The world has changed and we have to do things differently as we have done before. So I'm talking about the legal issues of data-based campaigning. What can we do? What's possible? What's not possible? Just to show you, there are different ways of campaigning. We now have the run for presidency in Austria. This is one of the candidates. This is a lady. This may be our future Donald Trump in Austria. He's also from bricks and mortar business. And yeah. And then we have Sebastian Kurz, who ran a very successful campaign. And in this campaign, we supported Philip, who did all the web programming and the campaigning. And what we did, you see it here, this is one of the things we put in there from the legal side. So I will show you a bit what you have to put into such a campaigning website to get things right. Why do we... Oh, this is stupid, there should be written campaigning without data is not possible, but campaigning without data protection as well is not possible. Processing of personal data basically is forbidden. That's the fun about it. In whole Europe, it's basically forbidden. It's really that simple, and you need to look if you get an exception and are able to process the data. And that's the funny thing about political campaigns. All the exceptions you can usually use, like giving consent, interests of the data subject, overriding legitimate interest, you can forget about this. You need here in a political campaigning typically an unambiguous consent. So it's really affirmative action. Somebody has to say, yes, I opt in here. So it's nothing about opt out. So you really need to opt in here. That's what the law is saying. It's the European Data Protection Directive, and the Austrian Data Protection Law says the same. But behind there is this European directive, so you really have to be a bit careful about it. Why? Because political opinion in the European Union is regarded as sensitive data, like health data, like data about your sexual life, political data, which party are you interested in, is sensitive data in the European Union. It's under special protection. There is an exception which is very difficult. You see it On the text here, we marked it in different fonts and sizes to show you that yes, you may process political data if you are a political party from your members, as long as it's your members and they have displayed their interest and on a regular basis and you are not disclosing the data and not disclosing it to third parties without consent. If you keep it in your organization and don't do really much with it, then you might work without consent if it's a party member or really someone who say, okay, I'm interested in there, then you might use it. But you see, it's a very complicated text and you can do things wrong and then people come and say, okay, that's not fine. So my opinion is it's better to get people to get an opt-in and then you're on the safe side. And how do you do this opt-in? That's how you do it. That's from the Sebastian Kurz campaign. I just copied into it. It's the German consent text, but it's just you need to tell the people, okay, what categories of data are we going to process about you? What's the purpose? We will send you information, inform you on events. Are we going to transfer your data to somewhere else, the third party? You have to put this. And you need to tell the people that they can revoke their consent and give them some sort of an email address or so, and this needs to be managed. So you see, that's basic what you need to do in data protection to get consent. It's just two paragraphs in the end, so it's not that much. You can implement this on your main website, and if you do this and have get this text right, you're on the safe side. You're the perfect opt-in of the people, and you can work with that, and you don't fear that there might be something wrong from the legal side. Yeah. there are some formal issues. For example, if you're doing such campaign things in Austria, you might need to think about if you have to notify this to the Austrian Data Protection Authority. For political campaigning, you might even need to get a prior approval in Austria to do this from the Austrian Data Protection Authority. So this is very formal in Austria. There are other countries where it's less formal, but there might be countries like France or Spain where you as well need to do some notifications. Yeah, so think about this if you're in a country where formalities are quite strict, that you might need to do something there. Another issue that I want to just shortly talk about is cookies. Of course, this is an issue. You can put cookies on your website and then you might have technical session cookies. That's basically okay, but if you really do tracking cookies and want to learn more about the people, learn more information about it, you need to inform them in advance. So again, here you have sort of an opt-in before you put the cookie. So you need to get this technically right. Before you put the cookies, you have to inform the people. You know this from website where you put the banner on top, say, okay, we use cookies, or on the top bottom, you get some banner there, please accept our cookies. That's the way you want to do it. So in other countries, this has been more known since longer. In Austria, companies are just starting with it and learning it from other countries. So in Austria, we are a bit behind with this cookie issue, but we are starting to do this. Yeah. Besides cooking, we have another area of law, it's telecommunications law, which restricts you to send people SMS or email. It's electronic communication, and it basically says again there you need an opt-in. You cannot just spam people with emails or call them or send them SMS. So there are some exceptions from sending emails, but again it's complicated. So our suggestion is just put the disclaimer here. When you ask for the email, then just put a little text down there and then you can put some more information. But it's basically a few lines which you need as a legal text where the people put their email address and then you're okay from the legal side. So often it's just a few lines somewhere in the field where it is. You can implement this on the website and it's not destroying the whole optic of the website, so it's not that difficult. If you don't do it, then it can happen to you like it happened to Neo's party, political party in Austria, where short before during a political campaign, they sent a reminder to people saying, okay, remember you should go voting today or tomorrow or so. And it seems that they didn't have the consent of all the people, and so now they fear that they might face a fine of up to 58,000 euros. So the fines here for spamming or calling or sending SMS is quite high in data protection and telecommunication law. So be aware of that issue. Speaking about fines, I've got some information and a very big surprising present from the European Union for your campaigning future. You might have heard that 4 years ago, Viviane Reding, the former commissioner who was responsible for data protection law, started a European data protection reform project. So it was really 4 years ago, in January 2012, she held that speech, and when I first read it, I was like, wow, this is really quite nice what they put on companies, so this really have a big impact, and from the beginning I was really talking to media and said, we should really think about what we are going to do to business, to industry with these regulations. So the discussion then went on for 4 years, and the result was quite a thing. So I told you, unfortunately, it's present, it's from the European Union. This is your future. The future is if you don't get data protection right, you get a real hammer. So I have to show this. This is the big hammer. This is the big hammer. And this hammer is 20 million euros, which will knock on your head like, boff, if you don't get things right. So in Austria, we are talking about like 25,000 or 56,000 euros of fines. in the future, and future means in the next 2 years, so it will come into force in 2018, your fines you will face in data protection is 20 million euros or 4% of your global turnover. So if you're a big company, it will get really expensive. But if for small companies, it can get really expensive and really ruin your company if you don't get things right. So that's the message. It's really a very big hammer. So be really be careful about these issues, and the principles which I told you will stay the same. So you really need to ask, think about asking for real opt-in consent in political campaigning. So it doesn't make things easier. They don't say no. You have to don't think about legal issues and campaigning in the future. No, it's all getting very strict, and you really have to be careful about it. So, when I did this for Philip, I was really looking into campaigns of other people, other parties, and I found out that if you wouldn't like them and you would ask a lawyer to do something against them, you find really easy things to give them troubles on the data protection side, because many of them don't get the things too right. They try to, some others even don't try, and they have nothing in place. So there is really now the time to work on this issue in the next 2 years to get campaigns fine. Yeah? So my conclusion is, please think about processing personal data legitimately. If you place cookies on your computer, think about how you are going to do this. Contact persons rightfully, think about asking for consent, put a good consent text there. Then you're fine. If you ignore all these data protection laws, then you really can get problems now, as we have seen lots of this NEOS party, but really can get very, very big troubles in the future, because these fines will be there in May, June 2018. Yeah. Thanks.